Many people have alleged that the negotiations have been conducted so far in secrecy. It is true that when I meet my counterpart, Ambassador Froman, we prefer to do it without TV cameras being present. If you want to build confidence, you also need a certain degree of confidentiality. The negotiation guidelines summarize the EU objectives in the negotiations and could reassure citizens that there is nothing dangerous in TTIP. In May, I called on the Council to declassify them, and today I hereby call on them again to publish the negotiating directives. And that's why President Obama flatly stated in Brussels that he would not agree to any deal if it lowered the standards of protection, neither would the Commission. The internal market is low on barriers to trade and high on standards of protection. The same philosophy underpins the TTIP negotiation. We should remove protectionism, but keep protection. And where the gap in approach between the EU and the US is too wide, we just won't change our rules. We will not import any meat that is treated with hormones. We will not give a blanket approval of imports of GMOs. On the other hand, it's not because the US makes a claim that it must be wrong by definition. We should rely on the opinions of our own scientists in EFSA and not on ideology.
Es geht Wachstum und Beschäftigung und es geht nicht die Senkung von Standards oder Verbraucherschutz. Es geht besseren Marktzugang für unsere Unternehmen, große wie kleine, und es geht nicht die Zwangsprivatisierung der Wasserversorgung. Es geht die Abschaffung von Zöllen auf Lastwagen, Autos, Schuhen oder Klamotten, aber es geht nicht die Verschlechterung von Arbeitnehmerrechten. Es geht die Lösung der Problematik, dass ausländische Investoren noch immer oft benachteiligt werden, und es geht nicht die Beschränkung politischen Entscheidungsspielraums oder die Entmachtung nationaler Gerichte. Wir wollen TTIP. Wir wollen es aber nicht jeden Preis. Wir wollen ein TTIP, wie im Verhandlungsmandat umrissen und in der Resolution vom Mai 2013 dargelegt. Daran werden wir den Text am Ende messen. Das werden wir als EVP am Ende sicherstellen. Und nur dann werden wir dem Abkommen zustimmen.
And we do accept that this agreement could and should benefit consumers, and that's why we welcome the fact that the Commission has involved consumer groups, NGOs and trade unions in the European discussions on priorities. For all of these reasons, the Socialists were proud to be at the birth of TTIP, and we do not want to have to be its assassins. And I want to tell the Commission clearly now, though, that if we have to be, we will be. And that's why we want the Commission to listen carefully to our concerns. And we have concerns about public services. And again, we've had assurances from the Commission. But we want to make sure that our public services remain of the highest standard and receive the highest possible protection. We want to make sure that in this trade agreement, there's no ratchet effect and there's no ability to prevent member states returning health, education and other vital services to public control if they've been privatized.
On nous explique aujourd'hui que ce serait bon pour l'Europe. Non, on voit bien qu'aujourd'hui, ce dont a besoin l'Europe, c'est de définir son projet, c'est de renforcer son projet avec une politique industrielle, avec une spécificité de durabilité. Et ce que nous propose cette négociation, c'est de diluer le projet européen dans un grand marché transatlantique.
For our group, jobs and growth without government investment, but also the opportunity to set global standards and to meet competition from emerging economies, as well as lowering bureaucratic burden that's unnecessary, remain the essential points on the horizon. And we have to find ways to preserve our cherished standards when it comes to food safety and the environment, as well as fundamental rights, such as the right to privacy. These are points that are raised by people all over the EU, and I think it is good to have an active debate. Transparency and active engagement are essential to acquire consent at the end of the day. So my question is, how will you help dispel the sense that quite a few people have, that there's not enough clarity on where the process of negotiation stands?